Good day to all of you. Computer Shiksha is supported by. In the previous class, you learned about the options of the standard toolbar of spreadsheet and also practiced using some formulas. Let us do some revisions before we begin today's class. Can you tell how many sheets are there by default in spreadsheet? By default, spreadsheet has 3 sheets in it. What all options can you see in the status bar? The status bar shows information about all the sheets, shows you the zoom box, and also shows you some of the formulas. Can you tell what is the maximum count of rows or columns and sheets in a spreadsheet? A spreadsheet can have a maximum of 104,8576 rows or 10,48,576 rows. The maximum number of columns in a spreadsheet can be 1024. A spreadsheet can have a maximum number of 256 sheets. Can you tell what happens with the use of spelling and auto check option? If you have made a mistake in typing any words in your document, then to correct the same, you will use the spelling and auto check option. You may use the shortcut command F7 also for this. If you want to find the largest value from a row or column, what formula will you use? You will use the maximum formula for this. Can we calculate the average marks of the 10 students? Yes, in a spreadsheet, we can calculate the average marks of the students with the help of the average formula. Can you tell in how many ways you can save the spreadsheet document? You can save your spreadsheet document in 3 different ways. First method is to use the Mino bar. Secondly, you can use the standard toolbar. And thirdly, you can use the shortcut command Ctrl+S. What happens with the odd and even option? With the use of odd, you can get those numbers which are not divisible by 2, like 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. These are all odd numbers. With the even option, you can get all the numbers which are divisible by 2, like 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, which are all even numbers. Now you switch on your computers and open the spreadsheet file. Let us now begin today's class. Today you will revise what you learned in the previous class and will practice the use of some options. You will also get to learn about some new formulas. The new formulas that you will learn about are LCM, GCD, quotient, and radians. Now, you type some data in your spreadsheet file or copy the table being shown to you in the picture. And then use the standard toolbar to save your file on the desktop. Show this to your teacher, and in case you face a problem, then watch the video and learn from it. Now, let us watch this video now and practice how we can save our spreadsheet file. So, to save the spreadsheet file, there are various methods. You can use the save icon in the standard toolbar and click on it, or you can use the file menu or you can simply use the shortcut command Control plus S. If we click on the icon in the standard toolbar for save, this box opens. You can select the location where you want to save. For instance, we have selected desktop, and then in the file name, give a file name that you want to save this file with. So we have chosen class 2, we have written class 2, click on save, and you can see that your file has been saved. You can see in the title bar, now the title of this file or the name of this file is class 2. If you minimize this and look for in the location where you saved this file, you can see in the desktop class 2 is available. From the taskbar, come back to your spreadsheet file. So this is how you can use save in any by using any of the three methods. Now show how you will use the standard toolbar to bring up a new spreadsheet file and show the same to your teacher. If you face a problem, then watch the video. This video will remind us of how we can take a new spreadsheet file. So to take a new spreadsheet file, you can use the file menu or you can click on the new icon in the standard toolbar. As soon as you click there, you will get your new spreadsheet file. You can also get a new file by using the shortcut command Control plus N. So you can use any of these methods to get a new spreadsheet file. Now you will use some formulas on this file of yours, like date, time, month, etc. Now you go ahead and show how you will apply these formulas one by one. Firstly, go ahead and show how you will get today's date on your sheet. Then show how you will get the time. Next, show how you will get the month. In case you have a problem, then watch the video to see how we use the formulas. Let us now watch this video and practice the use of some formulas for now, date and time. So let's first write some titles where we want to apply the formulas. So in the A1 cell, we have typed current date. In B1 cell, we are typing a title for date, as you can see in the video. And then in the C1 cell, let's type month so that we can get or use the month formula here. So just below the current date title, let's get the now formula. So to use the now formula, type equal to now, bracket open, bracket close, and press enter. As soon as you press enter, the now date and time, whatever time and date is currently on your computer, as you can see in the bottom right side of the taskbar, the time is 10:10 a.m. and the date is 27th January 2017. So that is shown as your current date. Now to give a specific date, let's use the date formula. In B2 cell, we type equal to date. Then it says after begin bracket, type the year. So we type 2017. Then remember, you have to type a semicolon. If you don't type a semicolon, this formula will not be correctly applied. After semicolon, the month. So we have said 1 and the date is 28. Close the bracket, press enter, and you can see that the date appears in the format month, date and year. Then if you want to get the month from a specific date, from any date, you can apply the month formula, which is equal to, then you write month, M-O-N-T-H, and then begin bracket, which is shift and 9 key, and then select any date which is on your spreadsheet from which you want to find out the month. Close the bracket and it will show you the month which is in this particular date. So the month is January, so it shows you 1. So this is how you will be using current date, date and month formulas. Let's try another date. We type equal to date and then we have begin the bracket, type the year 2017, semicolon, and this time we are using 2 as the month, then semicolon, and the date is 1. Close the bracket, it shows you the date in the formula, second month, first date of 2017. Now if you look for the month in this date, equal to month, begin bracket, and then select this particular date, close the bracket, press enter, it will give you 2 as the answer because the second month was in that date. Let's try out the in D1, let's type time as the title because we next want to use time. So equal to time, then begin bracket, then you have to give hours. So you can type the hour that you want the time to be. So we are typing 10, semicolon, then minutes, again we are typing 10, semicolon, and then seconds we are saying 27. Close the bracket and then press enter and it will show the time in the format 10 hours, 10 minutes, 27 seconds AM. So this is how you can use these formulas for current date, date, month and time. Now you show how you can derive the factorial of some numbers like 5, 7, 9, 10. If you face a problem in doing this, then watch the video to learn how we can derive the factorial. Let us watch this video and learn how we can get factorial for a group of numbers or for any number. So let's first type the titles, numbers and factorial, so that we can type the numbers below that and then find the factorial below that factorial title. So we're just typing the titles here, numbers and factorial, and then we can type the numbers for whom we want to find the factorial. So we're typing 5, 7, 9, and 10. Now if you want to find the factorial, we will use the formula which is equal to fact, FACT, begin bracket, shift 9, and then select the number for which you want to find the factorial. So we select 5, close the bracket, press enter. So the factorial of 5, which is actually 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. That amount is 120. So you can get the value of this factorial 5. Similarly, factorial 7 equal to FACT and then begin bracket, select the number, close the bracket, press enter. Again, this factorial is 7 into 6 into 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1, which is 5040. For 9, we are typing equal to fact, and you can also type the number after you begin the bracket, close the bracket, and you get the factorial of 9, which is 362880. Next, we are getting factorial for 10, which is equal to fact. Then you can select the number 10, close the bracket, and you get, press enter, you get 362800. This is because factorial 10 will be 10 into 9 into 8 into 7 into 6 into 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1, which is also the same as 10 into factorial 9. So factorial 9 is 362880. Factorial 10 will become 362800. Now you close this file and go to the file which you had earlier saved. Now you will be learning some new formulas like LCM, GCD, quotient, radians, etc. Do you all know why is the LCM formula used? By using the LCM formula, we can get the least count value from a group of numbers, least common multiple. As you would have studied in your maths lessons. Let us now learn the use of the LCM formula by watching this video. Let us now look at this video and learn the use of LCM. Let's first select the sheet 2 from the spreadsheet so that we have a blank sheet. Now here we want to get an LCM or least common multiple of a few numbers. So we're just typing a few numbers, 6, 8 and 12. Now if you want to break down 6 into its factors, you will break down 6 as 2 into 3 because 2 into 3 is 6. Similarly, 8 can become 2 into 2, which is 4, into 2, which is 8. So 2 into 2 into 2 is another way of writing 8. Similarly, 12 we can write as 2 into 2, which becomes 4 into 3, which is 12. So that's another way of writing 12 in its factors. So 2 into 2 into 3. Now if you want to find the LCM, you can use the formula. So let's find the formula. Let's apply the formula here, which is equal to LCM, begin bracket, and then you have to type or get the integer 1, integer 2, integer 3, separated by semicolon, or you can simply select all the numbers for whom you are trying to find the LCM. So we select these three numbers, 6, 8 and 12, close the bracket. Once we have selected properly, close the bracket, press enter, and you can see that the least common multiple for 6, 8 and 12 is 24. So just to verify this from our knowledge of maths, we can write this in a separate way. You can see that 2 into 2 into 2 are the common multiples here for 6, 8 and 12. So we can type 2 into 2 into 2, and then there is also a 3. So we also have 3 into 3. So when we calculate this, 2 into 2 into 2 into 3, it is 2 2's are 4, 2's are 8, 8 3's are 24. So this way you can verify this value also. So this is how you can use the LCM formula to get the least common multiple for any numbers. Let us next learn about the GCD formula. Do you know why is the GCD formula used? Using GCD formula, you can get the greatest common value from a group of numbers, greatest common factor. If you are given a set of numbers and want to find out the greatest common number which can divide all these numbers, then you will use the GCD formula. Let us now learn about the use of the GCD formula with the help of this video. The next video helps us to understand how we can get the GCD of a set of numbers, greatest common divisor, which is also called as greatest common factor. So the numbers we are using is 6, 8 and 12. We already know that 6 can be written as 2 into 3, 8 can be written as multiples of 2, 2, 2, and 12 is 2, 2, 3. So the common factor amongst these is 2, because 2 can divide 6, 2 can divide 8, 2 can divide 12. So that is the greatest common divisor. If you want to do this with the formula, you can type the formula here, equal to GCD, begin bracket, and then select the numbers 6, 8 and 12, and then close bracket, and then you press enter. You can close this, templates has come by mistake. When you press enter, you can see that the greatest common divisor or the greatest common factor is 2 for 6, 8 and 12. This is how you will use the GCD formula on your spreadsheet numbers. Now on your sheet, show how you will get maximum number for all the data. If you face a problem, then see the video and take its help. Let us watch this video now and see how we can use the maximum formula. By using the maximum formula, we can find the maximum value from amongst a set of values. For instance, here we have in the F column maximum salary paid. So we want to find out the maximum salary which has been paid to all these employees. So we go to this cell, which is F2, where we will type the maximum formula, which is equal to MAX, then we begin bracket, which is Shift-9, and then select the values from which we want to find the maximum. So we select all the salaries paid, then close the bracket and press enter. Once you close the bracket, which is Shift-0, and press enter, you will find the maximum amount from amongst the salaries which we have selected gets shown here, which is 35,000. So this is how you can find the maximum value from a set of values. Next, show how you will arrange the data that you have in ascending order. If you have doubts, watch the video and learn. Let us watch this video to see how we can arrange our data in ascending order. So in this data, we already have the total salary paid to all the employees, and we have some data. Let's say we want to arrange this in ascending order, meaning from lowest value to highest value. So what we will do is we will select this data like this, and then from the standard toolbar select the sort ascending order icon. Once we click on that, a box opens which says, do you want to extend the selection, or do you want to apply it to the current selection, or cancel? So since we want to apply it to current selection, we will click on current selection, and you will see that your data has got arranged in ascending order. It starts from 25,000, which is the lowest, and goes up to 35,000, which is the highest. This is how you can use sort ascending order. Now you show how you will convert your file to PDF format and also apply a password on it. If you do not understand this, then watch the video. Let us watch this video and learn how we can convert our CALCI file into PDF format. So to convert the file into PDF format, we should go to the file menu in the menu bar, click there, and there are two options, export and export as PDF. So we can choose any. We have chosen export as PDF. Now let's click on security, because we want to set a password. Remember that all these four passwords in this box should be the same. So once we type these passwords, they should all be the same. Since we have made a mistake, when we click on OK, it shows us that faulty password confirmation is there. So we need to reconfirm the password. So we reconfirm this, click on OK, but it is still saying faulty password confirmation. So let's type the passwords again. You can set any password. So now we have set a 3-digit password, and all these passwords, 4 passwords, are the same passwords. This we are doing to apply security. Click on OK. Now you can click on export. As soon as you click on export, it shows you an address bar and a file name. So you can save it in any location on the computer with any name. We have saved it on desktop with the file name class2. You want to see this, minimize this file and look in desktop. You can see class2 PDF is there. You can open it by double clicking on the PDF file, and you can see that your file has been converted into PDF format. However, till the time you apply a password, it will not open, since we had already applied security. So it is asking for password. Give the password, click on OK, and you will see your PDF file. You can close this file now and look in the taskbar for your CalCI file on which you were working. Now show how you will get the minimum value from your entire sheet in a column. If you face a problem, then watch the video. Watch this video now to see how we can find the minimum value from given values in our CalCI table. So we are wanting to find the minimum salary paid from amongst all the salary data that we have already, as is being shown in this video. So we go to the G2 cell where we want the minimum value to come, and we type the minimum formula, which is equal to MIN begin bracket, and then select the values of total salary. After selecting, close the bracket by shift and 0 and then press enter, and you will see that the minimum value, which is 25,000 in all these salaries, is extracted and shown here. So this is how you can use the minimum value formula to find the minimum value from a set of numbers on your CalCI sheet. Now show how you will get all the data of any one column in descending order. Watch the video to clear any doubts you may have. Let us watch this video now and see how we can arrange in descending order or sort in descending order a set of values on our table. What we will do is we take the total working days, the column C, and we will select that so that we can arrange this in descending order. So once we have selected these values, we go to the standard toolbar and click on the sort descending order icon. As soon as we click on this, a box opens which asks us whether we want to extend the selection or work on the current selection. Since we want to work on the current selection, we click on current selection. As soon as you click there, you will see that your total working day column has been sorted in ascending order. In descending order, we were trying to sort in descending order. So 31 is the maximum number of days worked and 26 is the least. This is how you will use sort descending order. Since today's class will end here, all of you now close your files and properly shut down your computers. Today you revised and practiced some of the options that you had learned earlier. You also learned about some new formulas like LCM, GCD. Computer Shiksha is supported by. Thank you.